Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2043, SUMIFS. All right, I'm podcasting all of my tips from this book. Click the I in the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist to all of these videos. Back in the old days, Excel 97, they introduced two great functions called SUMIF and COUNTIF. Here's SUMIF. SUMIF says, go look through the range of rep names over there in column B. I'll press F4. See if it's equal to Allan Matz, comma, and if it is, add up the corresponding cell from column D. All right, now, hey, in the past, I might have noted that you could just put D2 there and it will automatically make the shape be the same, but that was bad advice because when you do that, this formula becomes volatile, and that's a bad thing. You never want to have volatile formulas. All right, so SUMIF looks through. Allan Matz had 1,543 units. And when we copy that down, we can see what each person did. This is great. They had SUMIF and they had COUNTIF. COUNTIF would tell us how many orders there were for each of those people. But this became a massive problem when we had two or more conditions. You had to switch over to using SUMPRODUCT. And I'm glad I don't have to explain SUMPRODUCT, at least not for this, because now in Excel 2007, they gave us SUMIFS. SUMIFS, that's where we want to see how many units Allan Matz sold of widgets. So we have to check both column B and column C. So the plural version, SUMIFS equals SUMIFS. And really, you could start using SUMIFS for everything because it's very versatile. It'll handle one condition or, you know, what, 126 conditions, 127 conditions, something like that. Okay, now here's the weird thing. Usually the SUM range was the last thing we specified. They reversed that and it's the first thing we specify. All right, so that's what we're going to add up. And then criteria range and criteria. So the criteria range one is look at all the reps over in column B. I'll press F4 and see if that's equal to Allan Matz. Now I need to be able to copy this to the right, so I'm going to press F4 one, two, three times. That puts a single dollar sign before the F. The four is allowed to change, but the F is going to be locked down. Comma, next condition, go look through all the product names over in column C, F4. See if that's equal to widget. In this case, I press F4 one, two times to lock it down to just the row. Alright, so Allan Matz, 1290 widgets and 253 gadgets. Double click to shoot that down. Not far to shoot it down, I know. And we can see for each of these people how many widgets, how many gadgets. Alright, so SUMIFS, new in Excel 2007. Here's the overview. Excel 97, SUMIF and COUNTIF. Excel 2007 introduced SUMIFS, it introduced COUNTIFS. It shortened SUMIF divided by COUNTIF into AVERAGEIF, and then gave us the plural version of that, average ifs. Then, several years later, Excel 2016, not all versions, you have to be in Office 365 and the February 2016 release. They added max ifs, min ifs, and ifs. Note here, they no longer feel compelled to give us max if and min if, and I agree with that because max ifs will do both. All right, Excel VNext, or maybe we could just, you know, look at the, it'll be about Excel 2026. They'll probably add another batch of these. And I'm hoping for Roman ifs and Arabic ifs. Okay, 40 greatest Excel tips of all time, plus another 30 bonus tips for Excel's birthday. All of them, all of these podcast episodes, going back to what, August 1st? Everything we've talked about since August 1st in this one book, $25 in print, $10 as an ebook. Click the I in the top right-hand corner, and you can get to those. All right, episode recap. SUMIF and COUNTIF have been around since Excel 97. They did not handle multiple conditions well. You had to use SUMPRODUCT, but then they added plural versions, SUMIFS and COUNTIFS. They also shortened SUMIF divided by COUNTIF into AVERAGEIF. Great, and that gave us AVERAGEIFS. Then, just recently, February 2016, they gave us MAXIFS, MINIFS, and the IFS function. There's a video on the three of those. I'll put a link right there. Yep, up in that eye there. Still, though, no Romanifs. Now, you know, I asked people what their favorite Excel tips were, and Nathie, Apsher, Scott, and Ryan all sent this in as their favorite tips. So thanks to them, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. You're still here. All right. I think Roman is one of the stupidest functions in all of Excel, although it was the birth of this book, Mr. Excel XL, right? My 40th book. But frankly, they really could do a Roman ifs, right? Here's how it would work. Equal Roman ifs. You add up these Roman numerals here, because it's the plural version, you have to put those in first, F4, comma, and then look through these regions, F4, and see if it's equal to east. And there it is, right? That, plus that, plus that, is that. Now, hey, I've got an Excel guru mission patch for the first person on YouTube who can tell me how I did that. It wasn't VBA.